They praised in unison your conquering hand, O Lord. For wisdom opened the mouths that were mute and gave eloquence to the tongues of infants. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion in the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, we praise God as we continue to rejoice in this octave of Easter, this one sweeping Easter day from Easter Sunday to Mercy Sunday. We call to mind our sins and how Christ has put death to death, how Christ has killed the power of original sin and wipes away our individual sins, for which we repent as we pray. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done and what I have failed to do through my fault. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us glorify God, who has given us his Son as our Redeemer, and in whom we live and move and have our being. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who have united the many nations in confessing your name, grant that those reborn in the font of baptism may be one in the faith of their hearts and the homage of their deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the crippled man who had been cured clung to Peter and John, all the people hurried in amazement toward them in the portico called Solomon's Portico. When Peter saw this, he addressed the people. You children of Israel, why are you amazed at this? And why do you look so intently at us as if we had made him walk by our own power or piety? The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. And by faith in his name, this man whom you see and know his name has made strong, and the faith that comes through it has given him this perfect health in the presence of all of you. Now I know, brothers and sisters, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did, but God thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away, and that the Lord may grant you times of refreshment and send you the Christ already appointed for you, Jesus, whom heaven must receive until the times of universal restoration, of which God spoke through the mouth of his holy prophets of old. For Moses said, a prophet like me will the Lord your God rise up for you from among your own kin. To him you shall listen in all that he may say to you. Everyone who does not listen to that prophet will be cut off from the people. Moreover, all the prophets who spoke from Samuel and those forwards also announced these days. You are the children of the prophets and of the covenant that God made with your ancestors when he said to Abraham, in your offspring all the families of the earth shall be blessed. For you first, God raised up his servant and sent him to bless you by turning each of you from your evil ways. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
O Lord our God, how wonderful your name in all the earth.
O Lord our God, how wonderful your name in all the earth.
O Lord our God, how glorious is your name over all the earth. What is man that you should be mindful of him, or the son of man that you should care for him?
O Lord our God, how wonderful your name in all the earth.
You have made him little less than the angels and crowned him with glory and honor. You have given him rule over the works of your hands, putting all things under his feet.
O Lord our God, how wonderful your name in all the earth.
All sheep and oxen, yes, and the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, the fishes of the sea, and whatever swims the paths of the seas.
O Lord our God, how wonderful your name in all the earth.
Our Easter sequence.
To the Paschal victim, Christians, offer a sacrifice of praise. The Lamb has ransomed his sheep. The innocent Christ has reconciled sinners with the Father. Death and life confronted each other in a prodigious battle. The Prince of Life, who died, now lives and reigns. Tell us, Mary, what did you see upon the way? I saw the sepulcher of the living Christ. I saw the glory of the risen one. I saw the angels, his witnesses, the shroud and the garments. Christ, my hope, is risen. He will go before his own into Galilee. We know that Christ is truly risen from the dead. O victorious King, have mercy on us.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Blessing, Father.
Lord, be in your heart, on your lips. You may proclaim worthily and well his holy gospel. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples of Jesus recounted what had taken place along the way and how they had come to recognize him in the breaking of bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts?
Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have. And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, who's acting here? Who's acting here? Who is it really? I'm talking about what's enabling this paralytic to walk. I'm talking about why the crowd witnessing the paralytic walking starts clinging to Peter and to John. I'm talking about what's happening in the breaking of the bread. I'm talking about why the risen Lord has to appear, and they think it's a ghost until he says, "Do you have something to eat? How about a fillet of fish sandwich?" He just, who's acting here? In spite of the fact that the man is paralyzed, Peter and John do not have anything to give to the man. You heard the gospel, the first reading yesterday from the Acts of the Apostles. He's expecting another coin in his tin cup. "Look at us," they insist. "We don't have a coin, we have Jesus Christ," in spite of the fact that the man is paralyzed, that his legs don't work, standing or, you know, laying there in Solomon's portico. It's this beautiful, beautiful ornate portico on the eastern part of the temple that was still standing in Jesus' day even. The Chaldeans did not destroy it, perhaps because it was so beautiful. There in Solomon's portico, "We don't have a coin to give you. Look into our eyes and look through our eyes into our soul. It's the risen Christ who is restoring your legs right now." Who's really acting here, letting that guy walk around? Who's really acting? Is it Peter and John? As the crowd then now embraces them and thinks, these two guys are fantastic. No, in spite of Peter's sin, we know it, he's denied Christ many times. In spite of John's human weakness, it's Christ acting in them and through them. In spite of the leaders of the church today, in spite of the priests of the church today, in spite of the laity, it's Christ acting. When the kingdom is manifest, it's Christ acting in spite of ourselves. In the gospel, the same disciples that just experienced him in the breaking of the bread now run and meet with the others in Jerusalem, right? They were in Emmaus, 7 miles, so they run back. Sure, it was like, you know, 30 minutes, 7 miles there. And share this amazing, you know, how he opened up their hearts, and then he was made known to them. It was him acting. It was really him in the breaking of the bread, in the Holy Eucharist. And then the same Lord now appears to the whole crowd, you know, assembled, wounds in his hands and side, and they are incredulous. They're fearful. They think they're seeing a ghost. It's him really acting. And he has to demand, "Hey, give me something to eat. Let me calm you down. Let me show you in ways your senses can grasp, it's really me." It's him acting. In the first reading again today, Peter boldly, you know, he's testifying, "Look, it's not us that have made this paralytic walk. It's not us alive in us. We're sinners. It's the living Christ. And you rejected him. You rejected the holy and the righteous one. And you said, you can kill him. We want you to free this murderer. We reject the holy and righteous one. We want you to free the murderer. Brothers and sisters, look around today. Does it look like the holy and righteous one has it his time right now? Or does it rather look like we've chosen to free the murderer? And later on, Peter goes and says, look, I know you've acted out of ignorance. That's a really, really important thing. Ignorance in scriptural language has little to do with intellect, okay? Ignorance means whether or not I have had the experience of the risen Christ. If I have not had the experience of the risen Christ, if I have not had the experience of the true God affecting my heart, then I am ignorant. You are ignorant. If I have had an experience of the risen Christ or the one true God affecting my life, we are no longer ignorant. I mean, it pertains to people who are intellectually really brilliant, but if they haven't had an experience of the risen Christ, they're ignorant of him. And likewise, people who are very simply educated, but have had the experience of the risen Christ, are very, very, you know, brilliant in the Lord, as it were. So it's not a book knowledge. It's not an earth knowledge. An experience of the risen Christ blows that out of the water. I remember in a classroom for Latin that was also used for youth ministry in my first several years as a young priest, there was a Latin inscription over the door frame. Okay, I'll go this way, over the door frame. And the Latin inscription translated said, to be ignorant is a terrible thing. To want to continue to be ignorant is a tragedy. We all have the risen Christ available to us. We all have the miracle of the paralytic walking, of our sins being forgiven, of bread and wine becoming his body and blood, of the word of God making our hearts burn with fire, of the truth of the kingdom of God. Yeah, it really is him. Christ is risen. Alleluia.
Truly risen. Alleluia.
So for our petitions to the Lord, we pray for the people of God through death. In baptism, we've been buried with Christ, and Christ rising from the baptismal font now lives and moves and has his being in each of us. Laity, consecrated sisters and brothers in religious life, deacons, priests, bishops, the Bishop of Rome, the Pope, for the church in this Easter season, renewal of joy, healing, unity, fullness of communion, full salvation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, Heavenly Father, for Father Rico. Allow your Holy Spirit that has called him to life in Christ through baptism and configured him to Christ in priesthood. Now also give him every spiritual blessing as he continues to minister. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Leo Kowaling, for his joyful repose, who has left this earthly life that through the death and resurrection of Christ, which he lived in this earthly life, God's mercy now permits him to enjoy eternal glory, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray with me for all those suffering the physical ravages of the COVID virus and the emotional and psychological negative effects of it. We pray for those who have died from this one particular virus. But really, those who have died from any virus, those who have died through abortion, which is a much more deadly spiritual virus at the core of this nation and many. We pray for those who have lost respect and love for the elderly or the marginalized. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bless us, Heavenly Father, who come to you in and through Christ your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for by your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
And blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for by your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Now pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Amen. Graciously be pleased, O Lord, to sanctify the sacrificial gifts we offer joyfully, both for those who have been reborn and in hope of increased help from heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but above all, in this Easter day, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death. By rising, he has restored our life. And therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. Even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. Giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, and spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Barry, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who've fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection and all who have died in your mercy, pray for Leo, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, the living. Pray for Father Rico, that with Blessed Mary, ever Virgin Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, and all who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through Christ, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At our Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that, with the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus, who said to his apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her the peace and unity in accordance with your will, who reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, be with you.
And with your spirit.
Amen. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem. Behold the Agnus Dei, behold the Lamb of God, he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Regina Caeli Laetare, Alleluia. Quiaque meruisti portare, Alleluia. Resurrexit sicut dixit, Alleluia. Ora pro nobis Deum, Alleluia. Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange, by which you have redeemed us, may bring your help in this present life. and ensure for us eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Brothers and sisters, praise be to God. Continue to celebrate the resurrection of Christ Jesus. Be sure to continue to ignite the domestic church, the church in the home, in the family, in the marriage, in the love of parents and children, in your homes. Also, all the spiritual goods of Holy Mass each day and all the devotions available to you in this COVID time of social distancing, please use the forward button on your phones and on your emails. It's your way of witnessing. It's our way of allowing the experience of the risen Christ to be available to those who have either never heard of him or in the past said no to him, and now it is really him. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father and Son and Holy Spirit. Amen. Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
To God our Father, and to Christ his Son our Lord. Thanks to God the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord God three in one. Hallelujah. God Most High, all who know your love now cry, Alleluia. Saints and martyrs round your throne,